Well, last year, we traveled about 46,000 railroad miles on the season. We unload 28 times and load 28 times. Transportation has been my end of the business for going on 26 years. I started out as a clown, and I fell and got hurt. And all the time, I used to hang around the train with George Brown, and Brown left, so I took his job, and I've been in transportation ever since. Well, I have charge of the loading and unloading of the train, the transportation and the movement of the show from one town to the other. We run in three sections. My first section is all flat cars and trucks, which we call a flying squadron. My second section is the hot section that unloads first on arrival with three coaches. All the bosses and everything ride the second. So when we get in town, why, everything is ready and the show is ready to go. My last section is all coaches. In other words, that's the performers and the people that follow up. So it's not just put it in and put it off and get it on the ground. It's still to see it's repaired. And when you take care of 70 cars and see if they're repaired at all times, you're doing a big job.
Before the show moves on to a location, the various shows, rides, and attractions have to be staked out on the exact location assigned to the various and many units comprising the entire organization. When the measurement for each unit is made, a stake with the name of the occupying show or ride is driven into the ground. The first thing on our lot is a cookhouse. It has to be, as it takes a satisfied stomach to get the best work out of any of us. Show business on setup day is a day without a night. Long hours are necessary.
I've been in this business. This is my 48th year. I started at the World's Fair St. Louis in 1904. I've been around the world with shows at least three times. The show operates with 10 diesel light plants. We have seven mammoth towers. That's lit with better than 18 kilowatt apiece. And one in particular, which is an outstanding feature, is the revolving tower that we always set in the center of our midway, which attracts attention from all directions from where we come.
Well, I work on the looper. I'm second man. My job is to keep it in, help keep it up in condition. See this running all the time. I was born and raised on the show. Well, I got 365 acre farm. Craig, Missouri. It's a little town. Population of 350 people. They ain't moved away. It's mine. I bought and paid for it off the shows. It's something you can't get away from. It's interesting. You're on the road, sure, it gets on monotonous and stuff like that, but stick your chin out and say, well, here we come. And you go on. And it's the people you meet. You meet all kinds of people all over the world. It's interesting. There's more education, I think, in a bunch of books.
Now, this is what we call a still date here, we open, as a rule, in the evening from about 7 and work till about 12 or maybe 12:30, and we call that a still date. But at fairs, when you work at a fair, you open from about 9 or 10 in the morning, and you work till maybe 12 or 12:30 or 1 the next morning, and you really do a lot of shows at a fair. Everything is going all right, and I like it here, and they treat me good, although it's a little hard work, especially at fairs, when you open in the morning and close the next morning, you do anywhere from 10 to 20 shows. You have to really like your work in order to do that many shows, and the question of why don't you get something better? People often ask me, what are you doing with the carnival, or especially in the sideshow? I said, well, if I didn't like it, I wouldn't be over here.
Ride I'm operating now is a kiddie boat ride. I have my family on the show. I have a daughter, which will be 19 this summer. She's a ticket seller on the show. I have my wife here. My wife sells tickets on the same ride that I'm now operating. I like the kiddie rides for the simple reason that I enjoy working with youngsters.
I've been in the show business 19 years. I've been riding the motor drome 12 years. And in those 12 years, I've had what you call one bad spill.
A sideshow is a funny show to operate.
We have to be on our toes at all times and just hope that we'll run into something new. I'll tell you about a two-headed boy that's right now in the state of New York. The boy is bright-minded. He's a quick-thinking child. Got intelligent faces on both heads and intelligent eyes. And I believe that that child is so much better off out in the show business, earning his living and making money. And a boy like him can make enough money to where when he got up in years, he'd be independently wealthy. He'd have nothing to worry about. He'd be out in the world, he'd see people. People would see him. He would become accustomed to the fact that he did have two heads. And they're just so much better off, I believe, being out where they can see something than they are laying in a room in a hospital bed all their life.
I've been a funhouse operator now for going on 20 years. Altogether, I've been in show business 42 years, all told. I started when I was 11 years old, working in a high wire act. The act was finally broken up, and I went from working a high wire act to an animal trainer. For several years, I worked as a lion trainer. From there, I went to handling large snakes. Getting away from animals, I decided to branch back into a funhouse operation, which had no dealing with animals of any kind, but was still a means of staying in show business, which is my first love.
I'm what the general public could call a parker. But among the show people, it's a talker. Perhaps you notice in my speech, I have a little impediment in my speech. Well, I've stammered ever since I can remember. But when I stand up on my belly to talk to the people, to tell them about the show inside, it's a peculiar thing. The stammering all disappears, and I don't stammer anymore. And how did that come about, I don't know. In other words, this is my 43rd year in show business and enjoy it very much, every inch of it. And it looks as though that I'll spend the rest of my days in show business.